So I found an error. Apologies. Tiny little boo-boo. We have to change this, but we haven't gone too far. So sorry, this should be 2z. Then this would be 3z, right? Let me double check that now. I'm paranoid. Yeah. And then this would be 3. Oops. This would be 3z. Okay, so now that we have two equations and two unknowns, y and z, we can go ahead and form a new system, the resulting linear system, and we're going to go ahead and solve that for y and z. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take 14y minus 4z equals 10. And then I'm going to also take negative 4y plus 3z equals negative 1. And the way that I'm going to treat this resulting system of linear equations is I'm going to try to eliminate z by kind of cleverly multiplying each of these. So this one I'm going to multiply by 3. And this one I'm going to multiply by 4. So if I multiply the first equation here by 3, I'm going to have a negative 12 for my z. And if I multiply the second one by 4, I'm going to have a positive 12 for my z. And so those will cancel out. So 3 times 4 is 42, I think. 30, 12, 42. Yeah, so I have 42y minus 12z equals 30. And then multiplying this by 4, I get negative 16y plus 12z equals negative 4. And I'm going to go ahead and add those together. So 42 minus 16 is 26. I'll have 26y plus 0z equals 26. So divide each side. Well, rather, I get then that 26y equals 26. Divide each side by 26, and we find that y equals 1. So if y equals 1, I can plug this into either of the two equations. So I'd have 14 times 1 minus 4z equals 10. I'm going to subtract 14 from each side. I'll have negative 4z equals negative 4. And then I'm going to divide each side by negative 4 so I get z equals 1. So now I just found that y equals 1 and z equals 1, and I can plug this back into. Either of the three original equations to solve for x. So just kind of out of, I don't know, laziness. So if I choose 1, so let's go see what that one looks like really quick. So that was 1 minus 4, 1 minus 2, 1 minus 4, 1 minus 2. Okay, so if this is my equation, then I can go ahead and plug in y equals 1 and z equals 1 here and here. So what I'm going to get is that x minus 4 times 1 plus z is 1 equals negative 2. So this is x minus 3 equals negative 2. So I get that x equals 1. And so my final solution is that x equals 1, y equals 1, and z equals 1. So kind of to take it from the top, we have a system of three equations and three unknowns. We manipulate that to make it a system of two equations and two unknowns. We solve that We solve that system of two equations and two unknowns, and then we go ahead and bring it all the way back to the beginning to find that first variable that we eliminated. So let's try it again. Last example. So we're going to eliminate x, right? That is the plan. This is the first main thing that we do. So if I have, again, 1, 2, and 3. So if I have x plus 3y minus z equals 6, and equation 2 is 2x plus y minus 2z equals 2. So this was equation 1. This was an equation 2. I'm going to cleverly multiply these by some number to get the x to go bye-bye. And the other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take 1 and 3. And cleverly multiply those by something to get x to go away there as well. So for the first pair, 1 and 2, I'm just going to multiply the top by negative 2. And I'm going to do nothing on the bottom. So if I multiply by negative 2, I'll get negative 2x minus 6y plus 2z equals negative 12. And then on the second one, nothing happens. So I'm just going to rewrite my equation as is. Ooh, wee, look how lucky we are. Okay, cool. I say we're so lucky because I'm just noticing another variable will also cancel. So if I go ahead and add these, I'm going to get 0x minus 5y, but look, also z cancels, plus 0z equals negative 10. So I have negative 5y equals negative 10. And right off the bat, we're so lucky we get that y equals 2. So that's awesome. Let's go ahead and still work with 1 and 3 as well, because the idea of eliminating x means that we want to solve a system of linear equations for y and z. So if I wanted to kill off x between 1 and 3, I'm going to multiply this one by 4. And then in the second one, I'm going to do nothing again. So I'm going to get negative 4x minus 12y plus 4z equals 24. And then no change here, negative 4x minus 7y plus z equals negative 20. So if I add these two, I think I'm having a senior moment. I'm multiplying by positive 4. So this should be positive, positive. And this one's negative 4z. Okay, so 4x plus 12y minus 4z equals 24. And then in the third equation, for the second line, nothing has changed. Okay, super duper. So I'm going to get 0x then I'm going to get 5y minus 3z equals 4. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to solve the system of y and z. So we had that the new equations we got were that y equals 2 and 5y minus 3z equals 4. So this one's easy to solve because we're just going to go ahead and straight plug in y equals 2. So before we did the elimination method on our system of y and z, and this one we're going to do substitution. And we're going to plug it into 5y minus 3z equals 4. So that's going to look like 5 times y, but we know, I think I'm losing my mind today. Y equals 2. So I'm going to plug in y equals 2 minus 3z, and that equals 4 here. So I get 10 minus 3z equals 4. I'm going to subtract 10 from each side. So I'll have negative 3z equals negative 6. Dividing each side by negative 3, I find that z equals 2. So then the last thing that we're going to do is we're going to use our values of y and z to find x. So remember that we said that y was equal to 2, z was equal to 2, and then we also have the original system of linear equations. So we can use this in any of the three equations. So last time we did one, so let's choose, I don't know, let's go for three. Let's see what happens. So for three, we get negative 4, negative 7, 1. And I think it was equal to 20. Negative 4, negative 7, 1, negative 20. Okay, negative 20. So that was negative 4x minus 7y plus 1z, or rather just z. And that equals negative 20. So we're gonna go ahead and substitute y equals 2 here, and we're going to substitute z equals 2 here. So that's going to look like negative 4x minus 7 times 2 plus 2 equals negative 20. So negative 4x minus 12 equals negative 20. Then I'm going to add 12 to each side. So I should get negative 8 equals negative 4x. Divide each side by negative 4. Huzzah, we're here, we're done, we did it. It's the end of the show. Here's our solution. X equals 2, y equals 2, z equals 2.